The coronavirus is especially dangerous to the elderly and those with underlying health conditions. Yet, it infiltrated the very places where the most vulnerable live.
The governor basically forced this issue and forced those patients onto those nursing home and rehabilitation centers. And, you know, he's now trying to blame President Trump and say, oh, we were following the CDC's guidelines, the White House directives. Well,
Queens City Councilman Eric Ulrich is calling for an independent investigation into the state's nursing home deaths. Governor Andrew Cuomo has repeatedly defended a state directive that has since been scrapped, ordering nursing homes to take in and readmit recovering COVID-19 patients. Most recently, Governor Cuomo said the state was only following CDC requirements, a decision Councilman Ulrich said left thousands unprotected.
It was a deadly decision, and one that no doubt in my mind resulted in the deaths of many vulnerable New Yorkers. That's why I'm calling for an investigation at the city level, because I don't expect one to come from the state level.
In New York State, more than 4,500 recovering COVID patients were sent to nursing homes before testing negative. Nearly 3,100 nursing home residents have died. The previous Cuomo directive disturbed elected officials across the political divide. In a statement, Democratic Councilman Mark Traeger said in part, quote, "The moment they knew asymptomatic people can carry and transmit the virus was the moment they had to do more than adhere to inadequate CDC guidance." Providers said they were never told they could transfer a patient who could not be properly cared for.
He left people vulnerable to be like sitting ducks, and they had nowhere to go. And so many people needlessly died because of the governor's bad decision.
Councilman Ulrich has requested a hearing with Council Speaker Corey Johnson to launch an investigation into nursing home deaths. We reached out with questions to Johnson and the governor's office, but haven't heard back from them yet. Jessica Easthope, Currents News.
If you're watching Currents News on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button and then click on the bell to get instant updates about all of our newest content, because we are putting your faith in the news.